recite ourselves in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My sisters and brothers, coming together to hear God's word and to share at his table of sacrifice, we call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who arrange all things according to a wonderful design, graciously receive the prayers we pour out to you for our country, that through the wisdom of its leaders and the integrity of its citizens, harmony and justice may be assured and lasting prosperity come with peace. This we pray through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the second letter of St. Peter. Beloved, wait for and hasten the coming of the day of God, because of which the heavens will be dissolved in flames and the elements melted by fire. But according to his promise, we await new heavens and a new earth in which righteousness dwells. Therefore, beloved, since you await these things, be eager to be found without spot or blemish before him, at peace. And consider the patience of our Lord as salvation. Therefore, beloved, since you are forewarned, be on your guard not to be led into the error of the unprincipled and to fall from your own stability, but grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To him be glory now and to the day of eternity. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
Before the mountains were begotten and the earth and the world were brought forth, from everlasting to everlasting, you are God.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
You turn back to dust. You turn man back to dust, saying, return, O children of men, for 1,000 years in your sight are as yesterday, now that it is past, or as a watch of the night.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
70 is the sum of our years, or 80 if we are strong, and most of them are fruitless toil, for they pass quickly and we drift away.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
Fill us at daybreak with your kindness, that we may shelter joy and gladness all our days. Let your word be seen by your servants, and your glory by their children.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
Alleluia.
Enlighten the eyes of our hearts, that we may know what is the hope that belongs to his call.
They came to him and said, "Teacher, we know that you are a truthful man and that you are not concerned with anyone's opinion. You do not regard a person's status, but teach the way of God in accordance with truth. So, is it lawful to pay the census tax to Caesar or not? Should we pay or should we not pay?" Knowing their hypocrisy, Jesus said to them, "Why are you testing me? Bring me a denarius to look at." They brought one to him, and Jesus said to them, "Whose image and inscription is this?" They replied, "Caesar's." So Jesus said to them, "Repay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God." They were utterly amazed at his words. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You haven't seen green vestments for a while. You haven't seen any vestments for a while either, except on the tube. The last time we wore green vestments was February 24th, the day before Ash Wednesday. And you know, after that, everything went to you know where. Repay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God. So how do we give to God what belongs to God? Maybe a more basic question still is, what belongs to God? And the only reasonable answer to that question is, we do. We all belong to God, regardless of our race, our class, our skill set, or our portfolio. We are God's. We are held in the hand and embraced in the heart of God. So the care of his vulnerable ones, the lifting up of his fallen ones, the mending of his broken ones, is giving to God what belongs to God. Now the struggle comes when we try to set a price on what belongs to God. We try to fix the going rate of coins we should give to charitable causes, to decide on the right dollar amount, on the good we do. But thinking like that is thinking Caesar-like. To repay God what is God's is a matter of attitude. Doing for those who are God's in gratitude for being one of God's own selves. We can only give to God through the currency of grace. We can reimburse God only in the capital of compassion and mercy. So, what is God's? Look to the people around you. That's God's. Thank you. himself, and he knows our needs. In confidence now we bring our petitions. For the Church, may the Holy Spirit instill in our bishops, priests, and deacons the gifts of wisdom and holiness of life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For elected and appointed officials, may God move them to enact policies that lead to the flourishing of all people, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our communities of faith, may the Lord allow his word to grow in us through our worship and service together, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, may the Lord welcome them into his peace and rest, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, we are yours, and we thank you for graciously hearing our prayers. Grant them according to your will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, who will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of the Holy Church.
Lord, accept the gifts we offer in this time of peril. May they become for us, by your power, a source of healing and peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through your Son, Jesus Christ. Jesus' death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy,
Lord God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna.
Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time Jesus was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving his father thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and once more giving his father thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Holy Father, Donald, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep, the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, and with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and St. Cloud, St. Peter, St. Paul, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. O God, from whose hand we have received the medicine of eternal life, grant that through this sacrament we may glory in the fullness of heavenly healing. This we pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.